This is time that we discuss Shakespeare's play Twelfth Night. And Twelfth Night is a romantic comedy, and it is also referred to as a satirical comedy. And Shakespeare has produced a very limited number of satirical comedies. And this is a satire. Twelfth Night is a satire, satirizing the Puritans. Shakespeare doesn't produce the plays in a satirical mood and not in the habit of attacking the contemporary political or social situations. Normally in the plays of Shakespeare, we don't come to find Shakespeare's reaction towards the contemporary issues. And in the play alone, in this play alone, we come to find Shakespeare reacting to the contemporary situation, attacking the Puritans. And therefore this play has been regarded as a satirical comedy. And interestingly, the play has got a subtitle also. Normally we don't come to find subtitles in the plays of Shakespeare. But in the university wits and the other plays, playwrights during the period of Shakespeare, we come to find subtitles. But in Shakespeare, we come to find only very limited number of subtitles used by him. And this play, Twelfth Night, has got a subtitle, What You Will. And there is one more play with a subtitle from Shakespeare, and it is the play Henry VIII, and the subtitle is All Is True. And for these two plays only, Shakespeare has produced the subtitles. And this play, Twelfth Night, has been written for presentation on the 12th night after Christmas. And the 12th night after Christmas is a day of great rejoicing. It's also called Epiphany, a holiday. And there is also another interesting story for the production of this play. Queen Elizabeth, after watching Romeo and Juliet, wanted Shakespeare to produce a play more interesting and comical, unlike the tragedy seen in Romeo and Juliet. And this may be the other reason why Shakespeare tried to produce the comedy Twelfth Night. And there are actually two plots in the play. And the main plot actually deals with the love. And the subplot deals with the servants in the house of Lady Olivia. And Lady Olivia is the female protagonist of the play. And the male protagonist is Lord Ursino. And Ursino has been wooing Lady Olivia for the last 7 years, but it is one-sided love. And Ursino has been trying to fall in love with Lady Olivia, but Olivia refused to fall in love with him. And Ursino is lovesick. And normally in Shakespeare's play, we come to find that there will be some source material. And for this play, Shakespeare has taken source material from an Italian production of a play called Glinganati. Glinganati means deceived ones. And it was a play collectively written by the academicians of a university called Accademia degli Intronetti. And the play was produced in 1531. And Shakespeare might have read the translation of this play, Glinganati. And the next source for the name of Lord Ursino is connected with the visit of a lord from Bresciano. And the visit took place in 1601 or 2, and this is this reason why we consider this play written after 1601 or 1602. The Duke from Bresciano, Lord Ursino, and he visited London in 1601. So he was named Virginio Ursini, and perhaps Shakespeare might have taken the name Lord Ursino from the name of this Duke of Brescianum, named Virginio Orsini. And we come to find that the male lead of the play is Lord Orsino, a middle-aged man in love with a lady, and it is only one-sided love, and the lady has not been showing any interest in Orsino, and Orsino has been wooing her for the last 7 years. And there are people, so in working as intermediaries in the love between Lord Orsino and Lady Olivia. And he uses his servant Valentine, the page in fact to convey his love messages to Lady Olivia. But the servant Valentine has been refused by the lady, even not permitting him to enter the house. And the lady sent him the news that she could not marry because she is mourning on the death of her brother also. So she had been mourning on the death of her father, and recently her brother also died, and in fact she wants to continue mourning on the death of her father and brother quite a long time, that there will be no possibility for Lord Orsino to wait for her. And she refuses the love request of Lord Orsino, and Orsino is lovesick. And in the very beginning of the play itself, we come to find the worried Lord Orsino, and he sings a song, "If music is the food of love, play on." Actually, he spends his time singing songs and listening to songs. And in the beginning of the play, we come to find that a girl named Viola, a young girl named Viola, has been saved from a shipwreck that occurred in the coast of Illyria, a coastal town in Italy. And the girl was coming with her brother Sebastian, and the ship was wrecked, and she was saved by the captain. And she thinks that her brother is drowned to death in the sea. And in fact, she wants to continue living by doing some activity. And the captain suggests her that it will be good for her to work under the Lord there. And he gives a picture of the Lord of Illyria. And he says that he is named Lord Orsino, a lovesick man, in love with a lady named Lady Olivia. And the love is a failure. And he is worried about the lady. And if Viola will go there, she will be employed by Lord Orsino. And Viola changes herself into a young man. So she undergoes the disguise of a young man named Cesario and reaches the court of Lord Orsino and becomes employed there. And since the page has got a beautiful face, because it is actually the lady in disguise, Viola in disguise, and therefore Orsino employs her to work as an intermediary for communicating his love to Lady Olivia. And we find the disguised Viola in the name of Cesario approaching Lady Olivia and communicating the love message of Lord Orsino. And the lady refuses Lord Orsino, but the lady feels love to the disguised Viola. And she wants the page to visit her again. And when the page leaves the house, she sends a gold ring with the excuse that the ring was lost by the page in the house. And the steward Malvolio is asked to retain the ring. Actually, no ring was left there. And Lady Olivia actually wanted to see the page the next day also, because she has fallen in love with him. And we feel that there is the effective disguise adopted by Lady Viola. And Lady Viola has been so very effectively disguised as Cesario. And Lady Olivia falls in love with Cesario. And very interestingly, the play has got a subplot. I told you that the subplot deals with the servants of Lady Olivia's house. And the most important among them is Molvolio. Molvolio is the steward there. And Molvolio is a Puritan. And I told you that this play has been regarded as a satirical comedy by Shakespeare. And he satirizes Puritanism through the character of Molvolio. And the play was for some time called Gulling of Molvolio. And the fooling of Molvolio is the subject dealt in the subplot of the play. And Molvolio is a Puritan. And Shakespeare didn't actually like Puritan administration. The Puritan London administration closed the theatres, and Shakespeare felt angry towards the Puritan movements. And this may be the reason why he lampoons a Puritan in this play, Twelfth Night. And it is the Gulling of Malvolio in the subplot. And the play was sometime called the Gulling of Malvolio. And Malvolio was a crowd puller. In fact, the people wanted to see the Malvolio scenes. The apprentice boys, who paid their pennies, stopped cracking nuts when Malvolio entered the stage. Malvolio was a crowd puller. And people mainly came to the theater to watch the Malvolio scenes. And therefore the play was called Gulling of Malvolio. In fact, to attract the attention of the onlookers. And I told you that in the comic subplot, there is Malvolio the steward, and he is fooled by other characters, the other servants and the relatives in the house of Lady Olivia. And the people who fooled him are Sir Toby, an uncle of Olivia. Then there is Sir Andrew Agcheek, a silly squirrel, brought by Sir Toby to court Olivia. It was Toby who brought Sir Andrew Agcheek, another comical character, in fact, to court Lady Olivia. And there are the servants also named Miriam and Fabian. And there is also a fool called Feste. And you see, ask the question, the name of the fool in Twelfth Night. The fool is named Feste. So in the comic subplot, we come to find the Gulling of Malvolio. Malvolio, the Puritan steward, is fooled by the people attached in the house of Lady Olivia. And there are people like Sir Toby, the uncle of Lady Olivia. And then Andrew Agcheek, a silly squire brought by Sir Toby to marry Lady Olivia. And there are the servants like Maria and Fabian. And there is also the fool named Feste. And Sir Toby and Andrew Agcheek engage themselves in drinking and merrymaking even late into the night. And it prompts Malvolio to chastise them. Malvolio in the habit of asking them not to continue drinking and eating cakes and making merriment late in the night. Malvolio, being a Puritan, was against drinking and merrymaking. And so Sir Toby very interestingly asks him, "Dost thou think, because thou art virtuous, you think that you are virtuous, that there shall be no more cakes and ale in the house?" And very interestingly, the cake and ale has been used by Somerset Maugham as title for one of his novels. We come to find a novel written by Somerset Maugham, Cakes and Ale. And so because there are problems between the people there in the house of Lady Olivia with Malvolio, they make a plan to fool Malvolio. They try to play a prank on Malvolio. And Maria the servant cooks up a plan and intimates through a letter in her own hand that Lady Olivia is in love with Malvolio. So she writes a letter in the hand of Lady Olivia, telling Malvolio that she is in love with him, and asking him to wear yellow stockings and such colorful garters and to be rude to the servants, and to smile in the presence of Lady Olivia Hulley. And Malvolio, even though a Puritan, becomes convinced on reading the letter that Lady Olivia is in love with him, and if there is a chance of winning Lady Olivia, so he is prepared to forget his Puritan concepts. And Malvolio starts acting out the contents of the letter, and finally becomes locked up, and at the end he becomes locked up in a dark chamber, and he is accused of madness. And meanwhile, we come to find Sebastian, the brother of Viola, so who was believed to be dead in the shipwreck, is actually not dead, and he is saved by another man named Antonio. And this man, Sebastian, arrives on the scene. And Lady Olivia, on finding him, thinks that it is Cesario the page, and she offers to marry him. She offers to marry Sebastian, and they become secretly married. And Sebastian and Cesario are siblings. And towards the end of the play, they appear in the presence of Lord Orsino. And at this stage, Viola so reveals her disguise. And when Viola reveals her disguise, so it is identified that Lord Orsino is in love with her. And the play ends in a declaration of marriage between Duke Orsino and Viola. And Sebastian has already got married with Lady Olivia. And there comes the news that Sir Toby has married Maria also. And all people are happy except Malvolio. And Feste the fool visits Malvolio in the guise of a curate. And towards the end of the play, Feste is again sent to placate Malvolio. Malvolio is the one and only character who is not satisfied with the conclusion of the story. And he is to be placated by Feste. Feste is sent there by Lord Ursino. And very interestingly, so Tom Shepard produced a film named Shakespeare in Love. And it was a British-American romantic comedy film. And it was directed by John Madden, and it was written by Mark Norman and Tom Shepard. And the film actually depicts an imaginary love affair involving Viola de Lesseps. And the playwright William Shakespeare is found in love with an actress while writing the play Romeo and Juliet. And the actress is named Viola, and the same name is used by Shakespeare in Twelfth Night also. And very interestingly, Shakespeare in Love is a comic film written by Tom Shepard and McNorman and produced by John Madden, and it won many Academy nominations. And these are the important things connected with the play Twelfth Night. Thank you.